Greetings, friends and Robloxians. Thanks for watching a Little Kingdom production. Here we are in Starscape, looking at a map of the known universe. As a noob, we start out here, in the center, the Citadel. Today, I'm heading out just to explore the farthest reaches of the known universe and to show you noobs some of the basic gameplay techniques I've learned so far. For you pro Starscapers watching, thanks for joining me, and please feel free to offer some tips and guidance in the comments below. I am just picking a random star in the farthest part of the known universe. The purple dots are systems in wild space, which is full of hostile pirate drones and players. All kinds of dangers out here, and adventures, and a chance to get rich maybe. To open this map, press M on your keyboard. You can plot a course to any system you want to go to by left mouse clicking on that system, and select Set Destination in the little pop-up window. If you want to go to a system that is only one step away, you can also use this warp button. With the chosen destination named Stespino, I don't know where they get these names from, but it's 46 jumps away, close the map either by pressing M on the keyboard or the Close the Map button on the left side of the screen. Now I press the space bar to pull up this quick warp menu. This shows all the destinations that are a jump away. Our current location is the Citadel. It has the yellow dot in the segmented circle. Now notice the system named Shield. It has a yellow star next to its name. This is to let us know that it's the jump in our plotted course on the way to Stespino. You can fairly quickly jump through systems using this method. I advise you get good at using the quick warp when jumping into unsecure and wild sectors. We'll look at that closer in a moment. Before you can even get into your spacecraft, you need to find the docking bay. A brand new player will have a few tutorials to complete, and there's a blue light beacon trailing ahead of you to show you where to go. Spawn your spaceship using the docking computer in the terminal here. The controls are very simple. On your keyboard, W is thrust forward, S is slow down and stop, X is stop completely, A rolls you left, D rolls you right, the mouse points you in the right direction, steering you up, down, left, and right. To land your spaceship in the dock, you level your craft, then press E on the keyboard until you are on the ground. Once safely on the ground, you can exit your spacecraft by pressing the space bar, which opens the canopy, and then you exit your spaceship as seen here. Another thing to note is that when you're stopped in space, you can press S to back up or reverse thrust. Before you can go out and explore like I'm about to do, you need to complete the tutorial missions. The tutorials are fun and simple. They earn you some coin and get you used to the gameplay while staying close to the Citadel, where it's relatively safe. In the very beginning, after learning how to fly your spaceship, you need to go collect some ore from the Citadel Planet Ring and then talk to the Corsec NPCs here who give you tutorial missions. I'm sure you can figure it out pretty quickly, but I want to show you some adventure and action. We're on our way to the far reaches of the universe. First thing to do when you come out of a jump is make sure you're safe. If there are enemies or NPC drones in the area, as a noob, you can just back away from them until they're off scanner or stop pursuing you. You can safely battle one or two drone fighters, but any more I think may require some advanced skill or even luck. Pay attention to the little radar display. It took me some getting used to. I basically try to get the trail lines behind the little enemy blip markers to know that I'm flying away from them. As long as I don't see them in front of me and I don't see their trail line, I'm flying away from them. Then, if they don't stop chasing me, but I have one or two away from the main pack, I will engage in combat. If my health bar gets too low, my shields, and then my hull gets damaged, I'll use that quick warp to get out of there into another location in the same sector. Don't choose another sector when you're in combat because it takes longer to rev up and get out of there. It's quicker to jump within the system, which makes sense. But then you might be jumping to another thick of enemies. Just jump again. Do that until you find a place without enemies. Inspect all spaceship wreckage for loot. If there's a little box with an X in it, and you get close enough, press F on the box and take the loot. Your ship comes equipped with probes. They find all kinds of good stuff and hazards in the system you're in. Launch them only when you're in a safe place. Press Control on your keyboard, highlight this solar system icon, and hold the left mouse button to launch the probe. Then the system map opens and you navigate your probe through the system. Your probe may discover all kinds of things like asteroid fields and monuments. When the probe gets near something undiscovered, its beeping gets more frequent and the trail starts to turn yellow, then red, then you're really close. The bottom left of the screen shows how many planets and anomalies there are to scan. With this probe, I found an asteroid field and a monument. Let's check out the monument. Navigate to newly discovered places using the Quick Warp menu or the system map. Just press the N key on your keyboard to access the system map. Monuments like this give you a temporary upgrade. Press F when you're close enough to receive the monument's blessing. This one gave me an increased shield strength for 30 minutes, right on. In this system, I found Wormhole, which is a great way to explore faraway systems and getting there quickly. But their destinations are seemingly kind of random. They're unstable, lasting only 48 hours for the most part. I love the way these things look. Everything in this game looks so good. Scan the wormhole by pressing C on your keyboard to find out how stable it is. Press F on the wormhole to enter it, and it warns you, it leads to wild, dangerous space. I have gone through many wormholes and always find that the space near the wormhole is free of pirate drones, but that's not to say that real-life player pirates aren't waiting on the other side, ready to receive you, or so I've been told. I have some tidbits of knowledge to share with you. I hope it helps you out while you travel deep wild space. When you are exploded in wild space, expect to lose your ship and most of your belongings. You will get a new clone body and will have your clothing items. You'll always get the starter ship, but that's it in my experience. All else is lost when you die out there, including any purchased or crafted ships and their upgrades. I advise you bookmark wormholes, try to get out of wild space, and look for a space station to save your loot before it's too late. It's likely you will get shot up quite a bit and exploded a lot. Don't give up. It's all in fun. Looking on the Quick Warp menu, notice the locations with these icons that represent space stations. I think the one with the C-looking mark is commercial, and the T-marked one is the industrial type of space station. There are several other types not shown here, but you may want to explore these stations for repairs, purchasing items, and most importantly, storing your items. When you come on a space station, if you have hull damage, you'll want to get it repaired right away. When you get close enough to this space station's repair module, the beam will reach out to your ship if it needs fixing, and your hull will be repaired. Not every space station has the same modules, so you'll need to search them out. You can identify if a space station has the different kinds of bays by their colors and shapes. If you have a bunch of ore and you need to refine it, this is what the refinery looks like. If you want to buy a new spaceship, the spaceship vendor has a light blue glow. The weapons shop has an orangish light, and general markets have green. A manufacturing bay doesn't seem to have any discerning lights, but it has this unique shape to it. Who knows, this might change in a future update, but that's what I've noticed as of making this noob tutorial video. Here I am in a space station, storing my loot in a storage terminal. I was talking to some nice folks at the Starscape Discord. Some friendly pirates showed me a screenshot of them killing and stealing another player's loot in an unsecured space station. So watch your back, even when in a space station. Please hit the like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment on this video, what you liked, what you didn't like, and any suggestions for future content. I primarily play Roblox Islands, but this game has my attention and is so much fun. I hope if you've never played it before, that you're inspired to get into Starscape and explore the universe. Thanks again, and remember, have fun and keep it imaginary.